Hey guys, welcome to my Twitch replay analysis. Today we'll be going over a Plat2 Twitch main named The Rat, and he is approaching 500 games played on Twitch this season. So let's see how he does. We're gonna start with matchups while they're loading into the game and getting to lanes. So it's gonna look like a Twitch Leona lane against a Caitlyn Naamine lane. So in my Twitch guides, both on Solo Mid and on my YouTube channel, I mentioned that Caitlyn is pretty much the 180 carry that Twitch can barely do anything against. So the ADC matchup in this 2v2 lane is pretty unfavorable for Twitch because of his super low range and his inability to get to her while she can do free damage and take no harass. Pretty much no punishment for her free damage. The support matchup here is going to be Nami against Leona, and Nami again can outpoke Leona in the early levels. And in general, it'll be the Twitch Leona lane in the back seat, and they have to be the reactors in the Caitlyn Nami matchup because they just have so much more range and poke and just harass potential in that lane. So it looks like they're just gonna help Rek'Sai start on the bot side. And even if Rek'Sai started in the top side, the Twitch Leona combo could probably not be able to take the Grump efficiently, so it wouldn't be worth it anyway. So this is probably the most optimal start for their team comp. So look out for what Twitch and Leona are gonna wanna do is that they're gonna wanna look out for overextensions made by Nami and Leona, because they have very good punishment game. As soon as they overextend into their minion wave, they can engage and all in that fight. But if Nami and Caitlyn play properly, they should be the aggressors in this lane and have lots of control. So it looks like they've already established a push. I like how he came here and tried to get an auto win to like try to thin out the wave. They're definitely not conceding, but stuff like this. So right there, the one thing you cannot do, especially in a no heal lane. Let me just replay that. You really can't be too forward and take free autos for absolutely nothing. So right here, your positioning is fine because he's trying to CS. And then I think that was still okay. That auto is, it was like pretty max range. But right here, she's obviously chasing you for an extra auto. She's obviously chasing this Twitch for an extra auto. So by no means should you turn around. If she chases you too far, the minion wave will come, and nothing is going to kill this caster minion right now. If you notice the wave, none of these have even got to here yet, and this caster minion has aggroed onto Caitlyn, so nothing will take your CS away from you. You really have to wait for your wave to come in, so Caitlyn cannot get a free auto on Twitch. But here he turns around because he gets scared that he's going to lose the CS and takes a free auto for the CS. And those stack up very, very quickly, especially if your lane has no sustain and their lane does. So eventually your health bars will just get lower and lower and lower if you keep making these mistakes. So right here, you should just back off, wait for the wave to come, and when the wave is just about to hit this, you can walk up and get it, and then Caitlyn will be less, well, be in a worse position if she is to walk up and attack you, because she'll draw aggro of your minions. So you kind of jumped the gun and took an extra auto there, which is unfortunate. Just right there too. You really, really have to be aware of her ranges and just like missing CS is fine. You can sort of analyze this wave and see that you probably won't miss any under tower, and you just have to try really hard to get them under tower. Additionally, Leona is completely, like, these autos you cannot be taking, otherwise you will have no chance in this lane. You have to stay healthy and wait for them to overextend. So now that your lane's roaming, because your Rek'Sai invaded, there's probably nothing you guys can do. So I think it's right that you guys stay in lane, but I suggest that you guys should be pushing this a little harder, because one of the easiest ways to win a lane that's not favorable is to get a minion advantage in that lane. Because they won't be able to attack you for free. They'll take minion aggro. So I think you could have pushed this a lot harder than you have, but it's still okay because You're getting the wave back. Right here, that's a good punishment opportunity. As you can see, she's in your minion line right here, and she drew some aggro. That's your perfect chance to like fight her and punish her for that. So basically what I was saying before is that you really don't want to take any unanswered harass, especially against the heal lane where you have no heals, because you're playing the punishment role. You're waiting for them to make a mistake so that you can jump on it and take that opportunity. So really, like, all these autos you're getting are going to work against you in the long run of this lane, of this laning phase. But you have several tools to help you. So right here, this is a little of an... Okay, so that entire fight exchange was pretty interesting. I'll explain why. So, as Leona goes on her, you come on this side and stealth in here. Which is fine because you want to get the stealth invisible in this bush, but it's obvious that you're going to stealth regardless. So I think that if you just, instead of pathing around this way, because I have no reason why you did that, you could stay behind Leona and stealth forward, still get that auto attack, get that attack speed buff, because it'll probably proc. But you would have been able to be attacking Leona, I mean, be attacking Nami right away, as soon as Leona got onto her. But instead, you had to wait until she was bubbled for a while, pop out, and then start DPS onto this Nami. And because of that, I think you actually missed this kill, because if you had just walked straight forward and did as much damage as you could, threw down your slow quickly, you could have had a lot of attacks on her. You probably could have had 6 stacks already, but you wasted maybe 4 seconds trying to go in here and stealth. And that's why I think she's going to live in the end. She's very close to dying. If you had autoed her once more, which you could have achieved here, then she would be dead right now. So that was a mistake on your part. On the rat's part. Again, Leona's fighting, and I would argue that you should be upward more, because even though it's very obvious Leona's making a mistake here, you can still make your teammate's mistake less bad. it simply said, like, even though she might be doing the wrong thing, if you, as an ADC, go to help her, then things could still work out. But right here, because you weren't positioned and I think you focused too much on the minions, she just lost health for free when you could have been trading a little bit of damage. You probably could have got Kaylin to 3 bars of health here. So we got the Xerath roam. That's fine, that was just a little troll. I don't think there's much to be said about that. So now that you have the wave advantage, you want to keep pushing, because you have the lane advantage now. Now you're winning the lane, pretty much. Caitlyn's going to be able to die. She's used her sums, and you still have heal. So she has no sums, you have heal, you have the lane advantage, you have this warded. You should just be constantly pushing this wave. Just never stop pushing this wave at this point. Or you could back right now, which is also an okay idea. That's an okay idea as well. Since you have got that push, you're not going to lose that much CS. It's not the most optimal back because the wave is now getting here and Caitlyn's going to want to push it. You might lose a couple CS, but it's still a good back. It's still a decent back. So I wonder what you're buying. You're going Hurricane first? Okay. I disagree with this a lot. Attack speed in the early game is a weak stat. The strongest ADC stat in the early game, it's flat AD. So if you're going the classic Twitch build of IE or some IE, some attack damage a booster, like Yomu's, even Blade, you should always get that first before you get your Hurricane. or any attack speed item because it's weaker in laning phase. Now you've now that and even Caitlyn got a pickaxe on her back, even though you had more CS than her and more gold than her. So she's going to have even more of a lane advantage because of your item choice in the early game. So this is a big thing. Your fights are going to be weaker, your trades are going to be weaker, and it's just attack speed in the early game is a very weak stat, other than to CS. So make sure if you're playing Twitch and you're going any of the recommended Twitch builds, you get something with AD first in the build path because it helps you with laning phase. So right now, you don't really have a great idea of where Zac is. You have like no wards on this side of the map, but you do have tri-warded. I like how you're pushing the wave, but you really have to get this all into the tower, otherwise it will stay here and be very troublesome. So I guess you're just waiting and being safe for Zac? That's fine. That's not bad. I see him top lane, but you don't, so it's obviously... Okay, this is not a good idea. Okay. So this is not a good idea. You have to choose your fights properly. Twitch does so much damage, and with Leona who can lock someone down, you can, like, kill someone very easily if you're given a good opportunity. But right now, you guys are forcing it so hard. Look, their huge wave just got to the wave. It's a full wave. It's all full health. They even have extra minions from the last wave. Their wave is bigger than yours, and it's a full wave with cannon. You're picking the fight in their wave. None of your wave is like even close to you right now. You're going to pick the fight behind their wave. They're all going to give aggro to you, and then it's... Look, all these minions are going to account for almost 200 points of damage, and that's like a huge mistake here. Because if you had just waited, properly managed the wave, and then picked a fight or just harassed them, you could have extended this lead. But instead, you just trade kills like this and take all this minion aggro. Which in the end, actually, if you hadn't taken this minion aggro, you don't know how much it could have helped you. You don't know the circumstances in which you could have lived because you were only one auto... You died to one auto. The Leona's stun is probably coming up. So it's up. So if you had just been able to survive maybe one or two more autos because you didn't tank this wave, then you might have been able to live because Leona could just stun and you'd invis. So really, you have to be really, really, really ahead, especially in the early game, to make a play like this. Because this wave is way too big for you guys to be like fighting inside of it. And you guys are way too low level to be doing that as well. I'm just going to speed ahead to when you revive. So it looks like you picked up a pickaxe. See, I don't know why you picked up recurve bow first. You could have just picked up pickaxe. You had enough money. 1k to like 900. I guess you wanted to be more efficient with your buy, but in by doing so, you became less efficient because, you know, attack speed is shit in the early game. So yeah, you want to thin this wave out. Caitlyn hasn't backed yet, so you have an item advantage on her. So what you want to do when you have an item advantage is not let them back. You shouldn't let him back. You shouldn't let her back. You should be pushing this lane continuously as much as you can. Obviously trying to avoid free damage, but you have a potion still, and she doesn't. So you have these little advantages that you have to understand, and that's what really pulls you another step. Like, you have to look at all the small advantages you have and actually play around them. Because you might think they don't make a difference until you actually play around them and feel the difference that they make. So, again, you should be pushing this wave. You shouldn't be scared. You have the wave now. You have the wave now, you should just be pushing this wave as much as you can. Giving as many autos as possible. You still have a potion on her too. You can take some autos. You can trade with her. She has Nami, but that doesn't mean you can't push her up. And now she's... Okay. So that was... Hard to say, it was mostly Leona's fault. She's playing so far back, and she doesn't understand that Caitlyn is fighting you and has engaged you behind your minions. I'll show you in a second here. Right here? Look at all these minions that have aggroed Caitlyn. But look how far Leona is. She's running away. She doesn't want to fight this at all when you could definitely win. Leona has her ulti. She has all her spells up. She could lock her down for the entire duration and she'll just be dead. Right now, you guys should be all inning this. This is a good fight to pick because of how many minions she's aggroed. So, right here, Leona's let you take so much damage. You were full health. Leona's let you take so much damage while Caitlyn is in your wave. So that was mostly Leona's fault here. Yeah. You guys could have won this fight. Look at them and look how vulnerable they are. You could probably 1v2 them right now because they're in this wave, but... And with the help of Leona, you could have definitely done something. So that was mostly Leona's fault there. But again, if you see your supporters too far back, you don't want to position too far forward. You have to play around your team. You can't just say that it was Leona's fault 100%. You know, like, it's always your fault, at least to, like, some extent, that bad things happen. So right now, yeah, you guys should be just pushing this wave. You know they backed. Getting some vision control because they have that pink in there, too. Push it. Okay. So you should definitely never wait for the minions when your lane is not there. Freezing is not good. Don't freeze. And you can't freeze this anyway. If your lane is going to push regardless of if you're there or not, that means you have to push it faster than ever. So right now, your minions are definitely bigger. They're definitely going to push it. So you have to definitely fast forward that part of the minion interaction. Get it to the turret so it eventually will push back and stay in the middle of the lane. As well as make Caitlyn lose some CS. You get full minion pressure. So right now you see Talia, you should be using your invis and just getting out. This is good, look at this minion wave. Okay, it's good that you just open with your ulti. You healed too early, but that's fine. Oh. Okay. I'd say that fight you played pretty okay. So you open with your ulti, you know that you have to use it. You heal her, it's early, but that's fine. It doesn't really matter. You should be healing early. I think you maybe backed off too early. You thought the tower range was a little too close, but that's fine. It looks like they are gonna try. Okay, so the only thing is, as soon as you notice Talia here, I think you just didn't react fast enough because you could have invis'd and got past the wall that she was making before she even made it. If you had reacted fast enough, pressed your Q and just left. That's the only thing I can say. The rest of it, your team came, you knew to turn, and it was good. So your team's kind of trolling. It's fine. I like how you're sort of trying to follow them and sort of trying to maximize everything as well. So you should always be watching your teammates at least and then making a decision. You should at least be giving yourself that information. So that's what I like this Twitch player is doing. Very good. So I don't think you should back here. All of them are dead. You know you've just killed all of them. You can push this wave, get this 6, 7, get this 8 CS, extra 8 CS, which is like 100 and something gold, and deny them 100 and something gold because you'll push this into the tower. That's what you should be doing. You should never just back like this. Especially with your health, you should be in a good spot. And these wards. You have decent ward coverage to see if anyone's still coming. Look at this line. This is so good for you guys. But you decide to back here. This would be a very. Oh, okay. It's good that you decided to stay. But yeah, if you were to make that decisive decision, like, and just walk here and wait for the wave, you could have got it a little faster. Like, 3 or 4 seconds faster. Now you should definitely back. Okay. This is another mistake. You should not overstay. If you get a wave into the tower and no one's there, just back. Use that opportunity to back. That's a better advantage than getting damage onto the tower. Because any damage onto this tower is not gonna do shit. You really want your item advantage, your positional advantage, your timing advantage, more than this damage that you're getting. Because those other things will help you snowball this tower and get it quicker than this shitty damage onto the tower. And you're pushing an extra wave now, but now you've lost your optimal opportunity to back. And now you're looking for a fight. Which you don't have the favorable fight now. Because they've just backed and bought items. Look at Kaylin's items, look at yours. Right? Now you have the unfavorable back. You've lost that advantage. So everyone should really pay attention to the wave management. If you kill them, they're not and they can't get to your wave, they're dead. You push the wave into the tower and back instantly. It's the most optimal back. Saves you the most time, saves you the most minions. And look, because you did that back, you're gonna lose this wave. It's gonna hit the tower, you're gonna lose 200 gold. Just because you backed at that horrible timing when you could have lost 0 gold and made them lose gold instead. You're completely alone here. Yeah, look at all this gold you're gonna lose. Look at all this tower damage you lost too. If you had pushed and backed, you would have got here before they even got to the tower. And now you're gonna get dived. So watch, look at all these. So as you can see how like one small thing, it doesn't see, you probably can't see this or realize this when you're playing, but for higher level players, those optimizations will prevent things like that. If you had backed, your tower wouldn't be low, you wouldn't be able to get dived, you wouldn't have that wave at your tower, so you wouldn't be able to get dived, you wouldn't have lost all that gold. And just all those factors put together, that's exactly what was result of that simple missed back here. That simple unoptimized lost 20 seconds back. And look at this tower damage you got, and look at what happened instead. Look at what you could have prevented, right? All of this. So that's just one example of how something small and seemingly small could affect so many things in the future, and how why wave management and understanding the wave is so important. And that's a very simple concept too. I'll get to this in a bit. That's a very simple concept too. Just understanding to push the wave when your opponents aren't there, get your wave to their tower and backing. That's the most efficient back. So that was a good flash. Good escape. Yeah, you can turn on him. Nice. That's a very good play. That's a very good play by you. See, this Twitch, as a Twitch main, really, it seems like as a Twitch player, he really understands his limits. He understands his limits on the champion Twitch, but he's lacking general ADC, higher level ADC ideas. So commenting on his Twitch play and his Twitch mechanics, they're perfect. I wouldn't say they're perfect, obviously, but they're very good. They're good enough to be very high elo, or like much higher than Plat 2. He'd be somewhere in the mid diamonds for sure with the Twitch mechanics he's using. It's all his lane ideas and general ADC mechanics that are lacking here. That was an extremely amazing Twitch play, and he really understood that even though he's like one bar of health, he could really just make this happen, and he did. And he played it perfectly there. So as a Twitch mechanical player, that was perfect. But you could tell that he's lacking some lane knowledge, which is probably probably what's preventing him from reaching the next level of ranks. We'll speed it up here. So right now that you have no tower, you see Nami's mid too, you should just be pushing this. Look for dive and push this. So this is good by Leona. You can't really get her, so you should just get the tower. Your goal is to scare her from the tower, and if she gets too close, then you go for her. So you could be positioning, you should be positioning here. Because if you let her in tower range, then you risk tower aggro. But if you don't even let her in tower range, you can sit in her tower range and attack her, and you won't draw aggro, right? So right here, yeah. Exact mistake. If you were positioned here, which is completely safe, you saw Nami mid, they just fought, Nami just died. If you positioned here, you could have followed up with Leona, and this is an easy kill. You have her ult up, you have heal up to chase if you really want. Oh, they didn't kill Nami, but... Now look, you're positioned too far back, again. You're positioning and not watching your support. You really want to follow her. You can't just assume she's always wrong, because she might be wrong if she's there alone, but she might be right if she's with you. So you have to make that change. I think you're more bailed out of this situation because your team came down and roamed down. But you could have made that play with just you and Leona if you had just stayed with her. So really, just play with your team, follow your team, you know? Look, your kiting mechanics is not bad either. It's really just your knowledge and team play. Like, following your team. Less tunnel in general. It's better. Yeah, so you guys should just be pushing this tower now. Hope you guys do. Probably get it. Let's definitely get it. So you backed off good enough, but you can help your team. Oh, they killed her. Never mind. So right now, you're sitting on how much gold? 1700 gold. You can back. But you should. Again, this is another opportunity for you. Another exact situation where you're trying to back, but your team is forcing a fight, right? You never want to leave your team hanging. And I like how you're still sort of staying. I think you're waiting for your invis too aggressively, or not too aggressively, too passively. You should just walk up with your team, just be there with them, you know? You could still be up here with your team and out of vision. You can still invis somewhere here, but you're still like all the way back here for no reason. I don't understand that. You really have to play with your team more and understand that your team is there to help you. And being with your team is so much more effective. Look, yeah. You're tunneling super hard. Like, you're backing here? And you backed for like 4 extra seconds while Ryze is fighting and dying. It just seems like very selfish play or ignorant play. Like you're not realizing, you're probably looking at the shop or something, or you're just seeing this and you're not moving, you're not budging because you really just want things that just want to do what you want to do, but you really have to follow what your team does to maximize the benefit of everything. Yeah, like, look how late you were there. You could have probably gotten Nami with that. Maybe he'll get her anyway, but... You're just very late to react with your team, which is not good. You have to watch the map always. Always be actively making decisions. I don't know what you're doing here. I guess you're just looking for stuff, it's fine. But... Now that your team is like sort of fallen back here, now you can just push this and back. You should back now. Now is your opportunity. You see that he's backing, you should back. Just walk straight to dragon in case. Or path toward dragon, which is fine. Going mid is fine. This is a good opportunity to look for. He really understands how Twitch works, which is very good to see. He's playing all Twitch mechanics very well. You guys should not be sieging this when your Xerath is backing, your Rek'Sai is taking that, and your Ryze is walking toward top lane. You guys really have to watch the map. You have to watch the map, watch the map, watch the map. And understand what your team is doing and make a decision accordingly. You're pushing mid by yourself with your support. Ineffective. It's not going to lead to anything. Even if you get a couple auto shots, autos into the tower. The most optimal play would be coming bottom, taking this wave, pushing it out, and continuously pushing this out, controlling their bot jungle, until your team is in position to do something and in which you follow. So look at this time you're wasted just going mid. Even going to this is useless. Look where your jungler is. You're just making these calls, making these, you know, just not effective. You're wasting all this farm bottom and you don't have bottom pressure, even though you have all these towers. So you have to understand that this should not have worked. This is because they overextended and they are playing badly. The most optimal and right thing to do is to go bot lane here. Just because these kills were taken does not mean that was the right movement. This happened because you were in the right place at the right time. But if you were to push this, you're creating opportunities. They created an opportunity for you. You know, it's different. It's different sides of a same coin. I mean, not the same coin. They're just different things, but they feel the same. It feels like you've gotten two opportunities, but you haven't created it yourself. This is fine how you're hovering around here. This is exactly what you should have been doing here, in those bot lane skirmishes or extended fights. You should be watching for your team and seeing how you should react. Good day, you're hitting the tower now. Getting good damage on that. Holy. So, yeah, you got outplayed there. It's just fine. Happens. I like how you aim the tower in the end. This is just them making a play on you. You guys were extended a little too far up, but I think that was still okay. It was really like the Zac, AP Zac, like jump that was really surprising. But now you know to watch out for that next time. I'm not gonna watch. Nice. So yeah, as an ADC, especially if you're stronger than their ADC, and especially as an assassin ADC, you should be always trying to push waves, create control, and then you can, after you've created that control, you can move on to different things and different objectives, and after you've created that control, it's easier to find opportunities. But you're not creating opportunities by walking around mindlessly. You have to manage these waves. This wave has to be pushed to this tower and keep it pushed to this tower. And then you guys can roam for this top play. Or your team can roam for this top play. Again, like, I guess you guys are just brute forcing it. Your team's back here. You guys are outnumbered. But you guys are so strong, you guys just brute force it. And they've overextended, and you think that that's the right play, but it isn't. You guys have just... Like, I'll watch that entire thing again. Like, you guys brute force this? I'll watch it again. You get the red, you guys are going brooding this. And like, why is he up so far? It's glitched, it says she's level 1, but... She should not be here at all. This should not be where she is. Like, getting this inhib is free. It's correct to go for this inhib. But all these kills, right? All these kills here are their mistake. You haven't created this opportunity. You really... Okay, so... This is very odd to see, because your top tier turret has all their top tier turrets are still up, and your bottom side is all the way over here. But you guys are booting the mid with two of your members back here, right? Like, this seems like just very disjointed play. So, especially after you get this, you guys should be backing off. Regroup with your team here. Guess I can't pause the game anymore. Regroup with your team here. Look to get this wave down here. And look to get this top turret. Like, one or the other. You guys want to fully stay on bot side? Yeah, I guess I should watch that fight. My bad. The rise is not there. Wait for invis. Yes, so that's a big mistake again. You've already seen what Zac can do to you. To appear that close, it was very obvious that something was gonna happen. Like, you even have vision of this. You should have seen Zac. You should see Zac here. Oh no, they sweep it. But you saw him before it, and you know that he's sweeping it. You can see that the HP is going down. So like, right here, you pop out, and then you kill yourself. This is very, that's horrible Twitch positioning right there. So really, you've already seen Zac do that to you, and you haven't learned from it. That's a very bad thing. So you pop out here, Zac jumps on you, you insta-die, and you could have swept this fight. But instead, you lose it. You lose it because of your failure to recognize and realize Zac's potential, even though it's already happened to you once here. In an even more unfavorable situation in mid lane, for them, it was like a 4v1 and Zac still killed you. So, you're just not paying attention. You see Zac here all this time, you see him sweep it, and he could be anywhere here too and still be charging jump. You pop out, insta-die. And that's a big mistake by you. If you had just waited a little bit, let Zac jump on whoever, or not even came out, your team probably could have killed Talia by themselves, and you would have never died. So really use the length of your stealth. Use the length of your stealth, because it's so strong. Use the full length of your stealth. Getting red. So yeah, for all people watching trying to learn Twitch, you really want to use the length of your stealth during team fights, because it really catches people off guard when after they've blown all their cooldowns to kill that they need to kill you, and then you pop out. So that's fine. Good work. I like how you played a little more passively this time. You have a very good position. You know not to walk in there without like invis or something. It's very smart. So you're playing this fight a little better. For sure. That's fine too. That's good. That's really good. You guys can win off this now. Which I think you guys do. Again, you don't really want to jump the gun. If you have a like people advantage, you have mid open, you really want to be patient, because that's a very good opportunity to win the game. And just because you died there, that could mean you can't win the game now. And it looks like it does. Just because of that, just because you died there. Looks like that your team can't end the game now because you died there. So stuff like that, you really have to hold back on your aggressive over aggressive plays on Twitch, because even though you do so much damage, you really die in 1 second. Anything will eliminate you. You really have to be patient and think if now there is no opportunity, there will be an opportunity later. And that's okay. I can get that opportunity in the future, you know? Because you do so much damage and you're so impactful with just a couple auto attacks into their team that you really don't have to pop out like that. Nice catch. See there, you follow your support. It was a good play. You're taking this Baron without Rek'Sai, but that's still okay. I think it's okay. No. So, your team kind of won you the fight there, because you guys are so strong. But you should have definitely walked around. You can't wait for that. But I think maybe that's just you not knowing how Talia works that well yet. But you should have definitely walked around. Especially if there's a Nivea wall here, something like that too. You should try walking around, but keep watching the fight to see if you have to have back again. Looks like you guys win the game here. I'm just gonna speed it up then. Yeah, so I have a couple big points to make for this Plat 2 Twitch main. Your Twitch mechanics, this Twitch player's Twitch mechanics are insane. They are very, very good. He is definitely a Twitch master. The thing is, he doesn't understand how to play as an ADC in general. He doesn't understand the wave management. So going off of that, during laning phase, if you get some sort of advantage, you really, really, really just want to push the wave. If you're starting to win and they're lower, you really want to push the wave when you can. When you can and you have vision, I mean, by when you can, I mean when you have vision, you really want to push the wave whenever you can, because it will give you the pressure in lane. It will give you map control. It will allow you to take objectives. It will allow you to assassinate them if they overextend to the wave. It will do so many things for you and your team. And that's a key thing here, for your team as well, because it will give you bot side pressure. So whenever you can, you want to push the wave. Secondly, when you kill them and they can't get to the wave, you really, really, really want to shove that into their tower. So they lose those minions. You don't lose the wave that's coming next. And you get a good back timer. If you fail with that back timer, as you saw what happened with the bot lane dive and whatever, during the laning phase, that none of all things like that can be avoided if you understand how to use your minions to keep map control. Okay, that's the second thing. Third thing is, you really want to play. The third huge thing is you really want to play with your team. It looks like you're tunnel visioning and not paying attention to where your team is, or not reacting fast enough. It seems like you're playing way too solo, and you're not identifying the factors and choosing. You sort of want to do your own thing more, even though your team wants to do another thing. And I'd say at least 80% of the time, just following your team is the better thing to do. Following your team is the better thing to do. And you see that, like, in LCS, sometimes, like, three people get themselves killed because they follow the team. But that's the better call is to follow the team. A shit call that's as five is better than like a split random. Everyone wants to do their own shit and then things just turn out badly. So really just look what your support is doing. Start with looking at what your support is doing and trying to stay with your support most of the time, right? 20% of the time, you really have to make a judgment saying like, no, this is really, really bad. But all the times I've seen in this game where Leona is up, you are just too far back and not trusting them at all. So it's just like, you really have to trust your teammates more, even if it's solo queue, right? And the final thing is, in team fights, you really want to wait. You want to wait as long as you can to pop out. Or, sorry, not as long as you can, but you really want to be patient with your popping out of your stealth, because that is the most influential spell on Twitch, especially in the late game. Yeah, you could say your ulti gives you more damage, but if you don't know how to use your Q properly in team fights, you can't win team fights. And if you do know how to use your Q properly in team fights, you will terrorize the entire other team. You only need like a couple shots into them to annihilate them, regardless of the build. This build is, it doesn't matter. As long as you build damage and crit and attack speed, you're gonna annihilate the other team. And you were doing so much damage to the other team in this game. But you really have to be patient with where you're placing yourself in team fights, especially if you're invisible. You have to pay attention to all the factors and make a well-rounded and global decision about these team fights, not tunneled, right? So I think those are the biggest points. So thanks the rat for this replay. You didn't send it to me, I just found it on replay.gg, but thanks for being the subject of this replay analysis. And I hope you guys liked what you guys saw. Tell me if you want some more of this. You can catch me on my stream at twitch.tv/Plateezy. I'll probably be doing more of this because I have a minor wrist injury right now that I'm trying to heal. So I'm just like chilling from playing too much and maybe doing more review. But yeah, thanks for watching. Look forward to some montages, and I'm working on an Ezreal tutorial, and I'm gonna do commentaries for Ezreal as well. So look out for that. Thanks for watching. You can sub and give a like and comment if you like the video. Thank you.